Here is some of what he said.
My son Matthew did not look like a winner. He was rather uncoordinated and wore braces from the age of 13 till the day he died. However, in his all too brief life, my son proved he was a winner. October 6, 1998, my son tried to show the world again that he could win. October 12, 1998, my firstborn son, my hero, lost. On October 12, 1998, my firstborn son and my hero died 50 days before his 22nd birthday. I keep wondering, same thing I did the first time I saw Matthew in the hospital. What would he have become? How could he have changed his piece of the world to make it better? Matt officially died in a hospital in Fort Collins, Colorado. He actually died on the outskirts of Laramie, tied to a fence. You, Mr. McKinney, and your friend, Mr. Henderson, left Matthew by himself. But he wasn't alone. He had his lifelong friends with him, friends he'd grown up with. You're probably wondering who these friends are. First, he had the beautiful night sky, same stars and moon we used to look at through a telescope. In daylight, he had the sun to shine upon. And through it all, he was breathing the scent of the pine trees coming down from the snowy range. And he heard the wind, ever-present Wyoming wind, for the last time. And he had one more friend with him. He had God. And I feel better knowing he wasn't alone. Matthew's beating, hospitalization, and funeral have cast worldwide emphasis on hate. Good is coming out of evil. The world has said, enough is enough. I miss my son, but I'm proud to be able to say he was my son. Judy has been quoted as being against the death penalty. It's been stated that Matthew was against the death penalty. Both of these statements are wrong. Matthew believed there were certain crimes and incidents that deserved the death penalty. I, too, believe in the death penalty. I would like nothing better than to see you die, Mr. McKinney. However, now it's the time to begin the healing process. To show mercy to someone who refused to show any mercy. Mr. McKinney, I grant you life, as hard as it is for me to do so because of me. Every day, you celebrate Christmas, a birthday, the 4th of July. Remember that Matthew isn't. Every day you wake up in your prison cell, you remember you had the opportunity and the ability to stop your actions that night. You have robbed me of something very precious, and I will never forgive you for that. I give you life, Mr. McKinney, in the memory of one who no longer lives. May you have a long life. And may you thank Matthew every day for it.